What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to episode 15 of Stories, The Path of Destinies. The last episode, we was talking about being if this lock thing opened up to anything. I don't think it does.
The clouds parted. Go back to
the new game.
It was time to
continue game.
The rebellion was in trouble.
Crap.
Ravens are scouting for the secret rebel base.
Need a game changer.
They needed a game changer.
The last one, Lupino.
We're not anew that
using stabbing
it
us.
Catastrophically wrong.
But
he was
the bad
sure
guy.
He could figure out how to use it safely. Also,
I feel like I claimed.
A temple had risen out of empty desert.
We're gonna go with another Lupino story. I'd run through all of his.
It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty
monster.
Yeah. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course.
What is that?
Bernardo had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion.
He there?
And he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage.
That's new.
Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause.
Oh.
And maybe Renato could use that somehow.
Yeah, that's a new storyline. Yeah, let's go for it.
He couldn't quite
right?
put his paw on when he'd realized Lupino was working for the Empire. He'd never exactly seen Lupino sending coded messages to the palace, but he was sure. The rabbit had been on too many disastrous missions where he was the only survivor, or where he accidentally missed getting on the boat that went down to the abyss in flames.
Mm.
If Renato could prevent Lupino from getting back to the fleet with all the intelligence he'd probably gathered, it might be worth the trip.
It might be. Well, that's new. At least we're not playing the same levels over and over and over again. I'm sure it's the same level, we're just kind of got a different story to it. Makes things a little interesting. So, while we're loading up, I hope your day is going well. Hope you're enjoying it. Or if you're stuck at work, I'm sorry. On loading screen. Anyway, my day is going pretty well. I'm trying to get a little ahead of the game here with Christmas break coming up, and my kids probably aren't going to let me get a lot of this done. So, thought I saw the little save, meaning it was loaded. There we go.
This? They'd been on so many adventures together. Lupino had talked Renato out of prison at least 4 times.
At least.
And Renato had rescued Lupino from at least 2 lynch mobs.
Alright. Really? I want to grab him. Oh, jeez. Here I'm trying to do some other things. Just getting annihilated here. Well, just go ahead and get all this done.
But he'd always felt that the rabbit resented him. Lupino was hilarious because he was so down on himself and everyone else. But behind the laughs, he wasn't a happy camper. Was this payback? Or did the Empire have his little white tail in a vice?
Payback. Down this way. Just trying to get through all this. Through the news stories. Come on. Thanks for sliding over there.
There was still no sign of Lupino.
Super healthy
not
or helpful.
Was he hiding in the cemetery further down the road? That didn't seem like
it. We have a new skill. Oh, we got two new skills. Let's go. Hell him. Or we could max out our energy some more. Let's max out the energy.
Come in handy in a pinch.
That maxed out. That'll make it easier to revive or heal up. There we go. That's how we do it. Aw, come on. I had hit him before.
Betray him. The call was dangerous. Now, Renata had a fleeting idea that the two ideas went together somehow.
Somehow.
And then it was gone again. Oh, damn our ideas. They never stuck around when we needed them.
Come on. Killed. There we go. Run, 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 run. There he is.
Bloody and exhausted, Renato finally reached the Pino. The rabbit was practicing shuffling his favorite deck. Now that he knew what the rabbit was, there are a few things about him that Renato didn't find so amusing anymore.
Nope, not amusing.
You sent me an urgent message saying that you're in danger. Oh, I am. The ravens are coming. Now, I've got a clever plan to kidnap Zenobia. Renato wanted to clap shackles on the rabbit and shout, "You're a traitor, and I'm not falling for it." But if there was one thing Renato was sure of, it was that the core of the Sky River was dangerous mostly to its user. If he could put it in the Emperor's hands, all Lysander III might blow himself and his fleet up with it.
Boom.
Yes, that was it.
Here goes the dynamite. We'll go with the first one. Down to the traitor.
A traitor? I'm hurt. Said Latino.
Maybe he'll stab us again.
Why did you say that? We found your code book, said Renato. They hadn't, but he hoped Latino would blow his cover. You got me, said Latino.
Oh no.
And you know what? I don't regret a thing. It's always about you, isn't it?
Yep.
You're the pretty hero.
Yep.
You get the girl, you get the medal, and what do I get? Rabbit food.
I thought you liked rabbit food.
Yeah.
Go to hell, said Latino. And he made a gesture, and 20 ravens came out of nowhere and stabbed Renato to death.
Yeah, see?
He had tried something bold and paid the price for it.
God, we tried something bold. Every time we get killed. I guess I'm gonna have to run through that again and get back to Lupino. Choose the other option. Loady, 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 loady.
How had they come to this? They'd been on so many adventures together. Lupino had talked Renato out of prison at least 4 times.
At least.
And Renato had rescued Lupino from at least 2 lynch mobs.
All those lynch mobs.
Long live the Emperor! Called the Ravens.
Yes, long live the Emperor. Not. Yes. More? Nope.
But he'd always felt that the rabbit resented him. The Pino was hilarious because he was so down on himself and everyone else. But behind the laughs, he wasn't a happy camper. Ooh, was this payback? Or did the Empire have his little white tail in a vice?
Nope. I guess there's nowhere else to go, huh? Go through the door.
There was a pleasant breeze coming through that door. Had it been closed before?
We should have been able to go through. should definitely have been another way, because this chest is full of help that we don't need. Come on, game, get with it. I miss? Somewhere? Okay, is that blocked? Oh, here we go. The other way, get to him. Running, 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 running.
From dropships. He'd better get moving.
Everywhere.
If they got to Lupino first, the rabbit would give the Empire all the intelligence he'd been stealing from the rebellion, and they'd probably give him a medal. He'd have to be very careful about how he played Lupino. The slightest hint of danger to man.
Last time he killed us.
Rabbit. Bloody and exhausted. Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing shuffling his favorite deck. Now that he knew what the rabbit was, there are a few things about him that Renato didn't find so amusing anymore. You sent me an urgent message saying that you're in danger.
Oh, I am. The ravens are coming. Now, I've got a clever plan to kidnap Zenobia. Renato wanted to clap shackles on the rabbit and shout, "You're a traitor, and I'm not falling for you."
But if there was one thing Renato was sure of, it was that the core of the Sky River was dangerous mostly to its user. If he could put it in the Emperor's hands, old Lysander III might blow himself and his fleet up with it. Yes, that was it.
It's an interesting plan. Interesting plan.
Like a real hero. Brave and smart.
And
he told the rabbit all about the Sky Ripper's God's Eye core.
"I'll go get the core while you attack Zenobia," he told the rabbit. "But wait, I've an even better idea. I'll get the core and you attack Zenobia," said the rabbit.
"Right, yeah, that is better," agreed Renato.
Yes.
Perfect. The traitor would make sure the Emperor got the core. Now Renato just needed the Emperor to use the core. If he could only get something that the Emperor wanted very badly. Zenobia, he could save her and bait the Emperor at the same time.
Look at that. Lever planning. Lord Rinaldo. It's not going to work out. He's going to die anyway. But, yeah, what can you do? I guess it's just part of the game. Where you just constantly die over and over and over and over again.
Right. Now, all Renato had to do was fight his way through Zenobia's invading troops, sneak onto her ship and into her bedroom, and kidnap her without any of her dozens of guards alerting her. Then, he would rely on her love for him to convince her how evil her father was, so she'd run away with him instead of going back to her father, who was going to blow himself up. It did sound a little risky.
A little bit.
But Renato had a feeling it would work out somehow. It always did.
Craziness. I don't think I need anything there. No. Alright, there
it's
we go.
Personal, but your mother wears army boots. On her ears.
Whoa, on her ears. Jump me from behind. Come on. Isn't anybody there for you to power up? And you need to think ahead. Fill it up. We're nothing but health out of this.
A chest that shiny deserved to be opened.
How ridiculous. 10 health out of that. Since this is just right here. Grab this and then jump down the thing. Of course, it's only health. Don't give me energy. I don't need that. Oh, look, I walked through there and they put that thing up so I can't go back. All these things. Come on.
Well, the eyes have had it.
Yeah, that's, you know, ridiculous is that? Just jump in front of them. We are.
Rado was halfway to Zenobia's encampment when Lupino showed up. He was disheveled and distraught.
They jumped us. I barely got away. Oh, they got the core.
They got it.
Ooh, it was all going according to plan, thought Renato. Now he just needed Zenobia on his side. Yes, that was even better. The Iblis Stone. Zenobia could get it. And then the Emperor would have to pursue them. Wait. No. The gem would corrupt anyone. Even her. That's it, he thought. Even Lupino. Even though Lupino was already a traitor. It would turn him against his secret master, the Emperor.
Here we go. Now we're thinking.
He would make himself Emperor. And the Emperor would have to defend himself with the core.
Ooh, two birds with one stone.
He was a super genius.
Send Lupino.
This is terrible, Renata told the rabbit. If only I had gone for the Iblis Stone. But now it's lost in enemy territory. He handed Lupino a map.
Wow.
It gives the bearer so much power. We can only hope the Emperor never finds it.
Wow.
Said Lupino.
Hear the different tone in his voice.
I didn't hear anything. Rabbit ears. You go on ahead. I'll check it out. And with that, Lupino hopped off with the map.
Hoppy hop hop hop. Go in here. Need the chest that's in here, because I'm almost out of energy and almost out of health.
How intriguing.
Watch you. Aw, come on. I guess that kind of worked out. It's just nothing but energy. We already read that. Talks about how the Emperor's gonna sacrifice Zenobia. Jeez. Come on, I hit that. It's your ship.
Renato slimped through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all.
None.
She was curled up on her bed. He'd forgotten how beautiful she was. How sleek.
Sleek and soft.
He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She was made of smoke, and he noticed he had a very solid blade to his throat. Did you really think you could capture me? Purred a familiar voice.
Every time.
I just wanted to chat, said Renato. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? He needs a sacrifice. Someone who truly loves him, to make a bargain with the lost gods. That's a
vicious lie.
Like we've already seen this one.
That's crazy. Why would anyone?
They could make him immortal, an eater of souls. And with that, her eyes widen. She understood.
Got it all.
How he had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred. How he had slept in a burnt village. At midnight, the Emperor's victims had come to him in his dreams to tell him of the hideous eldritch rituals they'd been sacrificed in.
Yep.
He could still see those kittens and puppies.
Oh, not the kittens and puppies.
Their moist noses. You can't prove that. I've got a witness at the observatory.
Yep. Let's go there and see that it's all burned up. Was set to fire.
He couldn't tell her. Not yet. Why he was really here.
Zenobia about
he didn't
daddy.
Want her to be anywhere near the fleet when her father blew himself and Lupino up. So he told her about how the Emperor's obscene rituals had raised ancient artifacts out of the land.
Yup.
How he'd followed the appalling trail of the hideous horrors his majesty had perpetrated for the sake of his own immortality. Any of this ring a bell? He said. He
nope.
Told me it was all lies. You've always known when I was lying. I always hated that about you, said Renardo.
Always.
The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renardo had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred for one book.
Yep,
he
one book.
Burnt village.
And he gets massacred.
And puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them.
Up and away. Go the other way. I feel like we went that way. Not sure what's back here.
Fresh socks, thought Renardo. Please be fresh socks.
Fresh socks. Everybody loves fresh socks. I'm just curious. I don't think I've been through this one. It's quite possible that I have and just don't remember. It happens a lot on this game. Nice though if it just skipped you to the end. This way, up the spiral stairs. Bum, 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 ba-da-dum. There seems to go on forever. Aw, come on, come on. Putting a hurting on me. And I'm dead.
I should really look for another line of work, he thought. And then he died.
Kept getting to me from behind. Getting it from the behind. Time should be better, right? Keep bouncing from person to person. And they got me anyway. Nope, nope, nope. Well, at least it was the last guy. Give me a bunch of health. Much.
I could retire.
You read that one? School we learned the gospel of the transcendent emperor, the last divinity to pierce the skies, banish the evil old gods, and grant us the gift of time. Could one man divine as he be create something as intricate as time? I think it is a new one. Secret journal. Honestly, I think we just killed a bunch of time. Let's use this one. Let's go across this way. Yeah, no. That's not the way to go. Next time I know, just take the stairs. The elevator does not work. It's out of order. Fix it, game. Let's heal up a little bit. Get to a battle with only 65 health. That's the way I've been fighting. Now we got them. Now they're on the run. More? Alright. I guess that's not the way to go.
I'd know if my father started practicing black magic.
Yes.
Why? Would you join in? No. I'd destroy his books and I'd... Okay.
You're not completely wrong.
You're not completely wrong. They've resurrected one of his victims. Well, I mean, look, it's not exactly alive, but it can talk.
It can talk.
Witness, she said.
Up and away. Take him on to get there. Okay. Don't know if it's that part didn't load in or a secret. Yeah, I'm willing to bet it didn't load in. So I'm betting I can't. There we go.
It was an engraving. Maximum capacity. 130 people.
130 people. Taking these hits. It's not good. Take me there. Nope, nope, nope. Alright, so at least that was there. Those things. I hate those things. Like that takes more than one hit, like claimed. We get that death blow. All that health. And we're at the burning pile. What a surprise. What a surprise.
The observatory was a burning hulk.
dead scientists and black feathers everywhere.
Everywhere.
Special care to burn the reanimated witness to cinders. Zenobia stared at the carnage. He didn't want me to hear the witness, did he?
Nope.
Guess not. What's your plan? She asked. So, Renato explained his brilliant gambit. Sending Lupino to get the Ibla Stone, become super powerful and corrupted, provoke the Emperor into using the core against him, thus blowing up both of them, and hopefully the fleet too.
Hopefully.
Visit your council, she said, shaken. I want to help. Could he really trust her?
And last time she turned her back on us. Where the secret base, not so much. Screw it, let's take her to the secret base.
He made Zenobia see how evil her father really was. He wished she didn't feel this urge to join in the rebellion. After all, he'd taken care of the Emperor, right? Yeah, but she'd always been conscientious like that. She told him she had to go somewhere first. So Renato gave her the location of the secret base and they agreed to meet in the ruins. He had a very good feeling about this.
I don't have a very good feeling about it at all. One bit. He's going to betray us again. Everybody betrays this guy.
What had Zenobia been
sad is that?
What was more important than meeting the Rebel Council? Had he made a mistake? Sending her to the ruins?
Yep.
No. He knew they could trust each other. He could trust her because she never broke her word.
Never.
She could trust him because she could see right through him. Well, she'd probably be there well before him. She at least didn't have to fight her way to rainstorms of ravens.
Oh, rainstorms of ravens. To the rebel base before Zenobia. Got more than just that, but
Renato wondered how much Hypatia had known about the
well,
book she protected. Enough to tell her son
didn't
to
you do
it. Enough to tell Renato to protect her son. He'd let her down there.
Aldo, he lets a lot of people down. The one? What? Right. It cost me my combo. Can't use the altar. No point. Got me. They're all dead. All dead.
The bend,
oh, there's Lupino.
Unconscious on the side of the path. And Renato could smell a familiar, sweet, smoky scent. Mm. Who? Zenobia. It had to be. She never used a combat spell when she could use drowsy gas. That meant... She had the Ibla Stone. What would it do to her? She hated her father now. She'd kill him for sure. The council wouldn't mind if she killed the Emperor, but murdering her father would destroy her. He had to get to whatever ledge she was on and talk her down from it.
Yeah, that ain't gonna happen. Man.
These things really slice like ham.
Oh, we're dead. That's a little rough to get through there. Okay, we'll go this way. Activate that thing. I almost didn't make it there.
Stairs. So he was close to the rebel base. Nothing was on fire. So far, so good.
I'm gonna try to get through this with just 6 or 7 health. Well, at least we made it up to the 20 mark where we're killing everything with one blow. Go through here and see if we can get some energy or health back. I'd imagine we're gonna have to go through the fleet. Got a little health back. Rest my energy up while we'll get up there. Here we go. He has taken out everybody at the rebel base.
Everyone in the council chamber was dead.
Yep.
Zenobia stood shivering in the courtyard, drenched in blood.
Bitch.
Why? He managed. They started arguing with me. I lost my temper and I wanted their blood. Not me. The stone did. Why did you take it from Lupino? I had a plan. You had a stupid plan.
Stupid plan.
I'm going to go kill my father now. No, you can't. You'll just take his place. You'll become worse than him.
Yep.
Get out of my way, or I'll kill you too. Renata watched her board her ship and sail off. A few days later, the sun dimmed.
Yep.
A great void opened in the sky, black as the Imbla Stone itself. It stretched and ripped like a vast fatal womb.
Ooh.
And a gaze black and pitiless as the sun passed through the void into the land. And so the lost god Imbla's once again came into his own.
Scary.
Time stopped. He had tried something bold and paid the price for it.
Have to go back through that rebel base stuff? I wish it would just take you back and let you, you know, just pick the other option instead of having to go through the next that level again. But it is what it is. Keep going
what
through.
What had Zenobia gone off to do? What was more important than meeting the rebel council? Had he made a mistake, sending her to the ruins? No. He knew they could trust each other. He could trust her because she never...
They didn't have to go get this chest.
And she could trust him because she could see right through him. Well, she'd probably be there well before him. She at least didn't have to fight her way to rainstorms of ravens.
One health. Blow up. Off we go.
Librarians. People thought of them as fussy clerks who shushed them for talking. But the librarians thought of their books as sacred, and themselves as priests in a temple of knowledge. Who knew they were willing to die to protect it?
Right. Should be willing to die to protect their things. More blood. That way. There we go. I missed that thing over there.
Lupino. Conscious on the side of the path, and Renata could smell a familiar, sweet, smoky scent.
Sweet, smoky scent.
Zenobia. It had to be.
She never used a combat spell when she could use drowsy gas. That meant she had the Imbler Stone. What would it do to her? She hated her father now. She'd kill him for sure. The council wouldn't mind if she killed the Emperor, but murdering her father would destroy her. He had to get to whatever ledge she was on and talk her down from it. Boy, if looks could kill.
Right. Looks could kill.
The long stairs. So he was close to the rebel base.
It was on fire. So far, so good. About you. Open the doors.
Everyone in the council chamber was dead. Zenobia stood shivering in the courtyard, drenched in blood. Why? He managed. They started arguing with me. I lost my temper and I wanted their blood.
Blood?
Not me. The stone did.
Can't control
did
it.
You take it from the Pino? I had a plan. You had
a stupid plan.
She said. I'm going to go kill my father now. No, you can't. You'll just take his place. You'll become worse than him.
Get right.
Out of my way, or I'll kill you too.
Well, we got out of her way, and we died, so... gotta stop her.
He said. And I won't let you kill the Emperor. Enraged, she raised the sword. You hate him too? You could sense the Imbler Stone, yearning for his death.
Uh-oh.
But she didn't strike. If you kill him, he'll destroy you. I know you. Shut up! She shouted, her sword trembling. I won't lose you again. Not for anything. Get away from me!
Get away from
he
me!
Said, and he was very close. I can't lose you again. And he was in reach of a sword now. I hate him! I hate you too!
I hate him.
He said for the very first time. And then she was weeping. He was holding her. The sword had dropped from her hand.
Oh, look, there's a little heart
there. He
glanced
at the Imbler Stone. It was no longer the black of the void. It looked like coal. No. It glowed, like a cinder. It was crackling, burning, crumbling into ashes.
Uh-oh.
You've always loved me, haven't you?
Apparently.
She was weak. The stone had taken so much from her. Always, he said. She staggered as he helped her up. Let me take you away.
Where?
The island of Avalon. The sisters will heal you.
Yes.
He will follow us. Then we need the Farfarer. The fastest ship in the Empire.
Right. We'll have to see. I don't know if this is a new level or not. Probably the same level, just a different something. Or same level we've played before, just a different something. Yeah. That's the fleet one. That's okay. We'll get it done.
The Empire seized his ship. They'd have to take it back.
Up and away. There was a one to teleport right to the end. They're having to go through all this stuff.
Heavily guarded. Let's go someplace we didn't want it to go.
More of them. There we go. There's our 20. I'll die. One guy backed off the edge.
No shape to fight. But he never fought so well. He wasn't fighting for money or loot or a cause.
Nope.
He was fighting for her.
For her.
For them. His sword dance, his feet flew, and the ravens recoiled from his ferocity.
Wait for her. Made it through. We only need 1,400 more for another.
Oh, this really didn't have much in the way of safety features, did it?
I'm getting tired of all these battles. I mean, I guess it's part of the game, but. Constantly fighting this thing. I guess that's why at 20 they give you that everybody dies bit. 130 left until another level up, another skill point, which I don't know what to use.
And there it was, his beautiful skycraft.
Oh, so cute.
Though it fared very far indeed, beyond the Empire, beyond the reach of the Empire, to the mystical island of Avalon. He didn't know exactly where it was, but he knew he could find it. And they would find peace there. Second star on the right, and straight on till morning, laughed Zenobia. And they laughed together for the first time in a long time.
Oh, ha ha. Hot heal up action while I'm waiting for the next ship to roll around. Guess I could have got that chest. More people to kill. Leveled up.
Ready to blossom within him, or something.
Boom! 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 And they keep getting me. Bouncing around enough, I guess. Yeah, knocked him off. Can't forget that time. Remembered. Let's get away and get on our ship. Come sail away. Something not load? What the heck? Get back on that and go somewhere else. That was a little tricky. More people to fight. Go, stopping them. Oh, jeez. Where is that thing? At least kill that. Oh, they got me. There's so much stuff there. Holy crap. Ridiculous. We're just gonna start setting a bunch of things on fire up here. Get some energy back. that yellow thing pops up. Man, you gotta get rid of that thing. There we go. Got a chance now. We're at 20. Bam. Thought I had it there. Thought I had it.
A very clever engineer named Elon Musk got his start making floating platforms. Not many people knew that.
Nope, not many. There we go, we got to the 20 this time. And then we lost it. That damn thing. Man, there's just so much shit was blowing up there. So I gotta be a little more careful what's going on around me. Holy heck. Thought we were good once we got to that level 20, but not level 20 combo of 20. Started killing everything. Everything started blowing up. Like that. Away from that guy. Got rid of that yellow guy. I have this one. Maybe not. We're crap. We got rid of that yellow one. Then we got killed. Come on! Slowly but surely, we're gonna figure this out. I went with the purple one because I'm supposed to have better. Use energy to get it faster. Aw, crap. I mean, the attack speed. That's where I was looking for. Words. Nope. Where you at, yellow one? I hit you. Thing that's got like 80,000 XPs there. Not XPs, HPs. On. This is just ridiculous. Alright. So once we get to that level 20, we're just gonna keep the hammer down. Just race through all this. Keep the hammer down, baby. Keep it down. Ah, lost it.
Oh, we made it.
But they did not go unnoticed. Scout ships lifted off, and a long lance of the Imperial flagship. Renato turned downwind to gain speed.
Uh-oh.
The Raven ships could pursue, but they couldn't close. The Fire Speaker croaked, "You'll return her and live! Go sacrifice yourself," yelled Renato. "Then you won't have her either."
Uh-oh.
On the flagship, the Emperor was readying some arcane weapon. It couldn't be. It was the core.
What happened?
Devastating beam lanced out.
We'll go away from the plan.
Renato zigzagged wildly to keep the Fire out of it. Now the Raven scout ships were closing the distance, and the beam was getting closer too.
Oh.
Then came a blinding flash, and the air was searingly hot all around him. There was a thunderous, deafening roar. He could smell burnt oak and burnt feathers and burnt flesh. But when he could hear and see again, they were alive and unhurt. And they were alone in the sky. Mm. Zenobia embraced him. They had done it. Through luck.
He actually survived that one?
Avalon, here we come, he said as he held her arms wide in the prow of the boat and let her feel its speed. Maybe the real Avalon is wherever we're together,
ooh,
she said. And so, after a bit of an argument, Renato and Zenobia went to one of the two Avalons. The one shrouded in mists, or the one in their hearts.
Aww.
But which one they went to, I'll never tell.
Of course you'll never tell.
He'd done it. He'd forged his own destiny. Well,
Hadn't
actually done it. But he knew what he would do. Renato smiled at the book.
Hmm.
He practically wanted to kiss it. The kid's sacrifice hadn't been in vain. He'd saved the book and saved the world. Renato owed him and his mother so much. Renato lowered the mainsail and let the Farfarer shoot forward in the breeze. Second star to the right, and straight on till morning.
Well, this time can't be it.
He would win.
Serious? I'm not gonna watch the credits. Not go back and do the other ones. Okay, Bloodstone and Skyripper are always active. Option can be toggled in the gameplay options. Okay.
The clouds parted
okay,
over the
so
Isles
we can continue. All right, I apologize. This episode went really, really long.
The rebellion was in trouble.
But,
Ravens are scouting for the secret
apparently
base. They needed
actually found the right path.
Pieces of the Sky Ripper had
yeah, yes. But all right.
It could go catastrophically wrong.
I gotta decide whether we're gonna continue doing this or if we're gonna go to a new game.
A temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis stone was hidden there.
Yeah, I guess so.
It was a dangerous artifact.
See you guys tomorrow.
It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster.